Hello everyone, Commissioner here, and I'm here to give you the highs and lows of week 11. So this was a very exciting week in the NFL and in the XFL. So let's go ahead and cover the NFL real quick, get that out of the way. So Chiefs win, Tom Brady loses. What else is there to talk about? We might as well move on, right? Okay, so yeah, those were two very good highlights of the weekend. But tell you what, there was some good football. I watched three games this weekend. I watched the Titans play, overtime, great game. Watched the Packers and the Colts play, great game, overtime. You know, Rivers won though, which kind of sucks. And then, of course, you had the Chiefs and the Raiders game, which was another close game. So the Raiders seem to have figured out some kind of kryptonite on the Chiefs. But with Superman, kryptonite only slows him down and doesn't take him out. So as was the case here, because they won in the first meeting, the Chiefs prevailed in this meeting at home, so they just swapped venues and wins. But hopefully the Chiefs are back on that winning streak again against the Raiders. So that is it for the NFL. Let's move on to the XFL. Okay, so big dog of the week, yours truly. That's right. And this is only the second time this year that I have got this award, and both times are the only two times that scores of 200 plus were scored this season. So the first time that I won it, like 2 weeks ago, was 201 points. This week it was 203 points. The last time was with McCaffrey. This time it was without McCaffrey. So feel good about this week that I was able to get that kind of point production with CMC out and Eckler out and all those guys. So that was a good one. I played my boy, Troy, the Rook, and I put my foot square in his ass. So I hope he's understanding what it's like to actually play in the big boy league now, where we don't use decimals and things like that to calculate our point totals. So I took care of business there. So it was 203 to 117 in that game. And then now we move on to Deadass Last. This is this person's second trip to the Deadass Last zone, and that would be Jeff Watson. Jeff Watson, he was defeated by Carl, 123 to 98. So wasn't his worst showing as far as Deadass Last scores go, but it was less than 100. I think it was the only team with less than 100 points this week. So with those two out of the way, takes us to the Eliminator. So the Eliminator is finally settled. And man, did it come down to a shootout. So it was just between me and John, and we were the two highest scores of the week. And it went neck and neck, man, until late on Sunday night when I started to pull away with Travis Kelce, so that he helped me pull away from John a little bit, and that pretty much sealed the deal. And then I just capped it off last night with Evans getting about 14 points, taking me above the 200 range. So congratulations to me. I am the Eliminator winner this year. This is my first time winning the Eliminator since we've started it, so I'm pretty excited about that. So $65 cha-ching in my pocket. All right, so if you haven't paid attention to what I've been saying so far, this was a really damn good week for the commissioner. So I am feeling good. Like I said, Chiefs won, Tom Brady lost. I got a high score. I won the Eliminator, and I locked off a playoff spot. So I'll talk about that in a minute, but I locked in a playoff spot. I beat my boy, the Rook, but not only did I beat him, but I knocked him out of the playoffs. So I brought him into the league and I took him out of the league. So he is officially out. Him and Carter have the same record right now, but because Carter beat him head to head earlier in the season, that gives Carter the tiebreaker, even if they were both went out. So the AFC is already settled. So Tony, myself, and Carter are locked into the playoffs on the AFC side. The NFC side is a completely different thing. But again, that was a great week for me. But so now I can take it easy and have a little stress-free action for the next 2 weeks. I still got work to do, so I'll tell you about that real quick. So with my playoff win or lock-in, I am now firmly in the playoffs, and currently I'd be playing Carter with Tony having the bye. So I'm 7-4, Carter's 6-5, Tony's 8-3. So here's the thing. Tony beat me head-to-head earlier this season, so if he wins even one game between now and the end of the season, he is the number one seed in the AFC. If he were to lose both games and I were to win both my games, then that gives me the opportunity to get the number one seed in the AFC, which I am hoping that I can do, especially with the way things have been going for Tony here lately. And I did this, by the way, Rook, I did this without CMC and Eckler and some without Adams. So I don't want to hear none of this. I didn't have Barkley and I didn't have Chubb, so can't win that way. This is the big boy league, right? Remember, I told you that. Everybody else is showing you that too. This is where men play fantasy football. All right, so over in the other side of the conference is the NFC. Currently, you've got Dan as the number one seed with 8-3. Got Bo with 7-4 and John with 6-5. However, this conference is definitely not as far from over because you still got these three guys. You got Milt, got Jeff, and got Carl. Two teams with 5-6 and Carl with 4-7, which makes it a little more difficult for him. But there is an opportunity here for, it's still wide open for anybody because Bo could take the number one seed. If he wins out and Dan loses out, those kind of things could happen. So it's still wide open over here. So you guys, you can't be sleeping, man. You can't be sleeping at the wheel. You got to make sure those lineups are set. You got to be working those waiver wire situations, trying to get those good players. So there's a lot that you guys got to do yet. And I'm not done because I got to try to win out so that way I can take that number one seed from Tony. That's right, Tony. You hear? I'm coming after that number one seed. All right, so I think that is it for me for this week. Thank you guys for all you do, making this league very special. I'm hoping that we'll probably see some other funny version of John's Game of the Week coming up for week 12. Don't forget, this Sunday is the second watch party that we're going to have. So get out there, get your draft cash. Some of you guys are struggling with draft cash, and based on looking at your records and some of your contracts that are going to be exiting into the free agent pool next year, you're going to need that extra cash. So hopefully I'll see you on Sunday. Get those videos posted. Get those comments posted. That'll help you out as well. I'm the commish, and I will see you around the league.